Welcome back to Primetime on ANC. The government's attempt to fix basic education in the country will begin this school year as it implements the K-12 program. Now, this involves adding two more years to students' secondary education, or high school.
Now, by 2018, government hopes the program will be fully implemented. But with reports coming out that there aren't enough classrooms and teachers, is the country ready for this kind of change? Are there clear guidelines for the program's implementation?
Now, for a discussion, we're joined here in the studio by ACT Teachers Partylist Representative Antonio Tinio.
Good evening.
Good evening.
Congressman, thanks for joining us tonight. Now, on face value, as I was saying earlier, it looks like a good program. I mean, who wouldn't want, you know, kids to be well prepared after they graduate from high school? But then again, when you take a second look at it, a third look at it, even a fifth look at it, there's a problem with money, the teachers, the classrooms, textbooks even will come into mind, even toilets and all of these infrastructure support facilities that are needed for this program to prosper. Now, your bone of contention here is we're not ready.
Exactly. As you said, the existing system, the 10-year basic education system, already has a lot of serious problems. We're not really in a position at this point to implement an additional, actually 3 years. So we're talking about kindergarten plus
2 years
the
2 years
of senior high school.
Right.
So this will create more problems. And in fact, the implementation began last year, not this June, but began last year with the kindergarten program. And what have we seen there? That program is currently grossly underfunded, and because of that, they have to rely on the services of over 30,000 contractual teachers. They are paid from 3 to a maximum of 6,000 a month. They have no security of tenure. Many of them are licensed teachers, but they have no benefits, no GSIS, no field health, and so on. Now, so is that the way that this program will be funded? You know, it will be based on just the exploitation of thousands of teachers. For one, I'm just talking about teachers. I'm not even talking about the classroom requirements. So, out in the field, in many cases, principals will tell you that they have to hold kindergarten classes
In
stairwells, in every kind of available.
You're going to say they have to hold kindergarten classes in the garden.
Well, yeah, under the mango tree and so on.
Actually, wherever the space is available, that's where they're.
You're quoting from the Department of Education order, exactly.
Yes, yeah.
You know, so that's the situation right now. So, you know, what about when the additional 2 years kicks in?
So you feel we're rushing into the program without being adequately prepared?
Yeah, we're concerned that the Aquino administration does not have the commitment necessary to make this program successful. Just in terms of funding, for instance, that's already a basic concern, given that we already have serious problems to begin with.
How do you even begin to compute what would be the sufficient amount or budget to successfully implement the K-12 program?
Well, the DepEd has the numbers. They know how many teachers are required. They estimate an additional at least 1 million students from the kindergarten
will be coming in.
To be coming in. And so, just based on that, they have certain
so they can do the
rules
math.
Of thumb. Uh-huh. Yeah, 25 per class. So you can, based on that, you can calculate the number of teachers,
classrooms.
The number of classrooms, and so on. So they have the numbers. The problem is, the DBM and the Malacañang in general is not putting up the money. It has other priorities. There's a lot of money, for instance, in the conditional cash transfer program. That's this year. It's almost 40 billion pesos.
Pantawid pasada.
Pantawid pasada. maraming mga pantawid, no? Mm-hmm. Pero yung para sa kindergarten, pangmatagalan, mm-hmm. ay kapos, kinakapos.
But you're not fully thumbing down this the whole promise mm-hmm. of the K-12 program, correct? Mm-hmm.
Yes, it definitely is necessary to have a universal kindergarten. It's also important yung additional 2 years, no? Mm-hmm. For additional, so in other words, for a higher level of high school education to be borne by the state, at least in theory, mm-hmm. ganon, no? Importante rin yon. But unfortunately, based on what we've seen so far with the kindergarten program, nakita natin yung mga problema.
Again, on face value, when you talk of volunteer teachers, because that's what the DepEd calls them, the volunteer teachers. But for ACT, it's a different animal altogether, mm-hmm. because they may call it volunteer teachers, but to you, it's really exploitation of the teachers in waiting, mm-hmm. teachers who just really aim to be regularized, to be regular employees. Mm-hmm. No? So what kind of a danger are we seeing here if this program goes on with this kind of a treatment insofar as the volunteer teachers are concerned?
We're very concerned about the status of the teaching profession, for one. No? We're already seeing, because of this kindergarten program, for the first time, DepEd implemented this massive contractualization of public school teachers. In fact, we contend that this is even illegal. This is against the Magna Carta for public school teachers. This is also against the Teacher Professionalization Act. Contractualization to bali ng mga teachers.
Nothing in the program says that, okay, we're going to hire them as volunteer teachers in the beginning, but then come next year, maybe 2 years later, maybe 6 months after, then we'll talk about it.
Well, there's no assurance whatsoever. Nothing. In fact, when we were deliberating the kindergarten law in Congress, we were for inserting a provision on the status of the kindergarten teachers. We wanted it to be explicit that the kindergarten teachers would be regular teachers in the same way that teachers in elementary and secondary are, and so they're covered by the salary standardization law, will receive the same pay and benefits. Tinanggal yon, no?
All right. At this stage, we'd like to bring into the discussion the Assistant Secretary of the DepEd, Tonisito Umali. So you've got three Tonys now on this newscast.
Tonisito, Tinio,
and the DepEd Asec Umali. Magandang gabi po.
Magandang gabi po sa inyo at sa lahat po ng mga nanonood at nakikinig.
Apa. We've already been discussing with Congressman Tinio about maybe some of the shortcomings that have accompanied the implementation of the K-12 program, at least even for just a kindergarten level. But now that we're looking at adding two more years to the secondary education, and we look at how much this would entail by way of salaries maybe or infrastructure costs, just how helpful is the national government in making this program successful in its implementation if you don't have the necessary budget support or budgetary support from the DBM?
Well, first of all, we're going to have a committee hearing in the House where we will confirm, and I believe Kong is aware of this, the DBM representative will be invited, and they will confirm that they fully support K-12. And that will necessarily mean the budgetary allocations that will be required for this to be implemented. That's number one. Mm. Number two, with respect to the additional 2 years that we're talking about, and of course, necessarily, we're talking about additional resources, additional teachers, additional classrooms, etc., additional books. This will only happen, the additional 2 years that you mentioned, Tony, will only happen in the years 2016 to 2018. What do we mean by that? The first batch of grades 11 to 12 students will only happen in school years 2016 to 2017, grade 11, and then 2017 to 2018, grade 12. So that means we have like 3 to 4 years to prepare for all the additional resources that we will need to implement the two additional years that you have mentioned, Tony. So that will be the answer to the concerns being raised. Mm-hmm. And between now and 2016, Tinio is fully aware that DepEd has manifested during our budget committee hearings that we intend to wipe out all the shortages within the next 2 to 3 years. We're talking about the present shortages.
Okay. Now you've given a timetable for when this present crop of students will actually reach that level where they will have 2 additional years of secondary schooling, right? 2016 and between 2016 and 2018, did you say, Asec?
Yes.
All right.
Yes, yes. That now, means, Tony, that if the bill is passed into law today, there will be no grades 11 to 12 that will be happening this school year or next school year or the next year school year. It will only happen in 2016 to 2018.
Okay. Now here's what I'm thinking, because we're looking at 4 years down the road, but 4 years down the road would be another government in 2016. And just how sure are we that in the transition from this administration to the next, that the budget or the funding for the additional 2 years will actually be there? I mean, how sure are we that 4 years down the road that the next administration will see it fit to continue the budget for this program?
Okay, Tony, first of all, if it becomes a law, the new administration will have no other recourse but to follow that law. And that law that we're talking about will be a law mandating 12 years of basic education instead of just 10 years, the present system that we have under the Basic Education Act of 1982, first. Second, that's why we're saying that we are going to prepare between now and 2016, and under the present administration, we will set up what it takes. We will prepare for all the resources that will be necessary to fully implement this by the year 2016 to 2018. So, theoretically, it should be all there by that year.
Okay.
Asec Umali, Carmina Constantino here. Let's set our sights now on the so-called volunteer teachers, because that really is the concern of Congressman Tinio, who is with us tonight. Let me ask you this. How many volunteer teachers did you hire or did you get help from when you started the kindergarten phase of this K-12 program?
Around 20 to 22,000, Karina.
All right, so 20 to 22,000. And what is the promise given by the government to these so-called volunteer teachers? Because what ACT is really looking out for here is the exploitation of these teachers. I mean, on face value, you can see that, okay, you're giving them jobs, but these are teachers waiting in the wings to become regularized in some school or another, Asec Umali.
Yeah. First, it is not the policy of DepEd to, you know. I know you just used the word, exploitation. Of course, we don't intend to exploit all these volunteer teachers. Second, we would like to state that it is well established that a kindergarten program is necessary. It is very important, especially right now, that we have now passed the universal kindergarten law. But even before this was passed, it is well established, students should enter some form of preschool education prior to entering formal elementary and, of course, higher years of education. Third, having recognized that, your government should develop a system, a means, a program on how to implement a program where it will address this concern that we should have some form of preschool education, and given all the limitations that we have, we don't have enough funds. So that's why we implemented a kindergarten program even prior to the enactment of this universal kindergarten law. And I would like to emphasize that this kindergarten program has been in place since 1972. DepEd has a kindergarten program, though, of course, it was only voluntary. Now it is mandatory.
Yeah, but Asec Umali, I hear you loud and clear, sir. And it's all about the kids. You want to take care of the kids. You want to get them prepared. But to take care of the kids also means taking care of the teachers who teach the kids. So ang tanong lang nila dito, paano naman yung mga guro? Yung mga guro nga, they can, if they can give their lives, they will give so.
Yes. Yes, yes. Can you know, just like what I said, you know, before I just forget this, but pardon me for interrupting you, please, ma'am.
Go ahead.
I just wanted to say that the commitment of the department and this government is to wipe out all shortages, and that necessarily mean teacher shortages. We should have enough teacher IT's. That should be what it means by wiping out all the shortages in 2 to 3 years' time. So the commitment is, in the meantime, that we cannot afford them, we are doing volunteer, you know, contracts. We enter into, we call them volunteers and we give them allowances. But in 2 to 3 years' time, if they are qualified and they will pass all the requirements, you know, we will have the teacher IT's in 2 to 3 years' time for everybody.
All right, let's hear it now from Congressman Tinio. What do you say to that?
Well, first of all, there's no debate about the necessity for implementing a universal kindergarten program. Having said that, and since a law has been passed to that effect, it's now incumbent upon this administration to implement it without violating the rights, the basic rights of teachers. No. Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, the assurance being given by Asec Umali that 2 or 3 years down the line they may be regularized is not good enough for the teachers who are working now. Ang isa pang problema na not only are they paid 3,000 to 6,000 a month, but they're paid 6 months. They receive their pay 6 months late.
Mm-hmm.
No, just because of all the paperwork that has to be done. No, so in that situation, medyo mahirap yata na. Tanggapin yon, no? And objectively, whether or not there is an intention on the part of the department, we say that's exploitation of the teachers. No? So, nung unang humarap sa Kongreso si Secretary Luis Tro, 2010, he said, I promise you, in 2 years, we will wipe out the shortages. Mm. No? And it's now 2012, and that's what the department is still saying. Well, in 2 or 3 years' time, 2 or 3 years' time, we will wipe out the shortages. In other words, parang napupush back.
Target.
It's a moving target, no? Mm. So, and given the budgetary allocations in 2011, 2012, we don't see that happening for the regular basic education program, the 10 years, and we're not seeing it for the kindergarten. You know, 1.98 billion lang yung naka-allocate for preschool education, same as last year.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, we don't see that these shortages will be adequately addressed, in fact, no? So, and we're concerned na yung pangako ni na Brother Armin hindi talaga matutupad yan.
Mm-hmm. You know, there are some suggestions that the government being very hard-pressed to come up with the money, even to finance or to put the budget, no, for public education, that they enter into these PPPs, the public-private partnership arrangements. Do you think that's going to be a good solution, especially for the implementation of K-12?
Well, during the budget deliberations, we raised some questions about their use of PPP scheme, because essentially what that will do, even though, you know, they can fast-track the implementation of infrastructure projects, in this case, classroom construction.
Yeah.
But it will, in the end, cost the government more, just because PPPs will mean that government has to pay for...
You'll be indebted to the private...
And government has to pay for the return on investment of the private partner.
Mm.
So that's the concern we raised regarding the PPP scheme.
Mm.
And even more of a concern would be if the PPP is extended to the delivery of education services. At this point, DepEd is not talking about that yet.
Mm.
No, but that is a global trend.
Mm.
No?
Mm.
And the effect of that will be further commercialization of public education, which is something we should be concerned
about.
When
it's supposed to be free, right?
Exactly.
Oh. All right. Well, Asec Umali, if we are to address the at least the doubts of officials like Congressman Tinio as to whether there is adequate funding as of now, and whether or not there are other viable options for funding like PPPs, I mean, where else can we turn to make sure that we get adequate funding for the implementation of K-12?
yung binigay po ninyo, Tony, the PPP program is a very, very important project of DepEd that will address the funding requirement. And you mentioned, aside from PPP, so that's the question. We have to remember that under the local government code, that the mandate of providing quality basic education to our children is not simply confined with the national government. It's also with the local government units. Right. And we have what you call the SEF, or the Special Education Fund. Okay. Malaki po yan. Okay. And in fact, yung iba pong mga guru natin na hindi po nabigyan ng regular plantilla item ng Department of Education, ay sila po ay pinapasweldo ng ating mga pamahalaang lokal. And it's a very, good source of funding, yung local government funds. Aside from that, DepEd has always entered into, agreements with our private partners where they will, we have this Adopt a School program where they will, big companies will adopt ABS-CBN, is one of our partners in doing this.
Yeah.
Those are just some of the sources of funds that we are availing of.
The local governments, their SES, Special Education Funds, are an important supplemental source of funding. But for one, that's highly unevenly distributed.
Because it depends on the IRA of the era.
Exactly. No? Yes. So yung mga malalaking syudad, they have a lot of resources. No? So Quezon City, Makati, etc. They pour a lot into education. But that's not true for the majority of local governments. And in fact, local governments, talking about contractual teachers, are among the most
notorious
for hiring contractual teachers. Mm. No, there are over 49,000 locally hired teachers, and a lot of them are equally exploited. Alimbawa sa one municipality in Laguna, mm-hmm. the teachers are paid at the rate of 175 pesos per day.
No kidding.
Ganon, no? So,
in Laguna?
Laguna, somewhere in Laguna.
Okay. Mm. But somewhere in Laguna, there are really a lot of unhappy teachers, unless they feel fulfilled just doing their jobs and not minding the pay.
Most of them are. It's a calling for most of these teachers.
Yeah,
but you have to keep body and soul together.
Raise families and
exactly.
so on.
Yeah. All right. Mm-hmm. Well, K-12, it begins the school year, but the additional two school years for high school will only be implemented by 2016.
What begins the school year would be the curriculum. A new curriculum will be introduced for grade 1 and for first year high school.
Okay, so yun ang beginning ng primary, elementary and secondary, the new curriculum. Uh-huh. Okay, so a lot of siguro the birth pains will be observed by the time school year 2012 rolls around. So babalikan natin siguro si Asec Umali and Congressman Tinio when that time comes. In the meantime, Asec Umali, thank you very much for joining us on Primetime on ANC.
Marami pong salamat at sa tulong po ninyo at ni Kong Tinio at ng ating Kongreso at Senado. Mm-hmm. Ito po ay magiging matagumpay. Ito makulaban po natin. Salamat po.
Salamat po. And Congressman Tinio, thank you very much for coming to the program.
Makakaasa naman sila that we will not drop the ball on this because this is very important.
I mean, you want to see Filipino kids grow up to be as competitive as their Asian counterparts, right? All right, well, the clock may be ticking for Metro Manila's U-turn slots.
We'll have that story for you in Primetime when ANC returns. Stay with us, please.